even some flooding this morning and in this afternoon. Meteorologist Daniel Grace has been tracking the storms for us today.
Yeah, luckily most of this moved out late into the morning, so it's allowed areas to kind of get all of that rain and drain it out, because we did have some extensive flooding in and around the New Orleans metro area last night and this morning, and then throughout the day yesterday. It was in Washington Parish and Pearl River County, so lots of areas being impacted by this rain. And the good news is we're going to start to dry out going into next week. Satellite and radar showing a much quieter picture than what we had this morning. There are a few isolated showers out there. Those are continuing to move across St. Bernard Parish and towards Central Plaquemines Parish. But I'm going to take you back to this morning. This was the wave that moved through about 5 to 6 a.m. We had the first round of rainfall move in around 11 o'clock to midnight. So that's the first round. And we saw more rain moving in, and this might have been what woke most of you up early this morning. There's a lot of lightning and those downpours which led to that flooding. The good news is those areas that saw the rain yesterday afternoon didn't get too much more after that event. But here is the 48-hour rainfall, and you can see where the heaviest totals were down toward parts of St. Bernard Parish. But look at the whites and blues. That is a lot of rainfall just in the past 2 days. In between Poplarville and Lumberton, almost 14 inches of rain, but 15 and a half just toward the east. 10 inches of rainfall in the Angie and Varnado area, and then down toward the South Shore, 3 to 6 inches, even higher amounts. You see that 10-inch mark just near Lake Bourne in St. Bernard Parish. So thankfully, we are going to start to dry out. That heavy rain now moving closer toward Florida, right now in the northern Gulf. We still have river flooding to deal with, and on the North Shore, there are still several areas where the rivers continue to rise, so it can increase those flood impacts. The Mississippi River at New Orleans, though, right now holding at 16.97, just under the flood stage at 17 feet. So we'll have to continue to monitor that. If you're near the Tangipahoa at Robert, the Pearl River at Bogalusa, or the Chifuncta at Covington, these rivers do continue to rise, and they are at moderate flood stage. We're in major flood stage for the Chifuncta at Folsom and the West Hobolachita in Mississippi, but those have crested and will continue to drop as we go over the next day or two. So if you live in those areas, you have those impacts to deal with here for at least the next several days. Now for some good news. The rain chances much lower for the start of the week. We'll reintroduce some sunshine. So tonight looking good. The clouds kind of hang tough, but by the morning I do expect some nicer conditions. You may see a coastal shower or two as we go into your Tuesday afternoon. I think most of that rainfall stays away further inland. So we are looking at some pretty nice days as we look at your 7-day forecast. Sunshine, temperatures warm and humid. Morning starting out in the 60s. Highs in the low to the mid 80s. Even through Friday, not seeing much in the way for some rainfall. Give us a nice break and able to dry out. Saturday and Sunday may see a brief shower, but it is going to be warm. Highs back into the upper 80s.